In this video, I'll tell you how you can win the title King or Queen of Catan. I'm Trichosaurus and I run the King of Catan tournament. I will also explain how you can become a Warden of the Crown. The first thing you need to know is that you can only gain the crown by winning in a game for the crown. For a game to be a game for the crown, it needs to meet certain conditions. The most important of these conditions is the involvement of the current King or Queen of Catan. You see, you need to beat the current king or queen in a direct match. Before the game starts, it has to become clear the game is a game for the crown. The reigning king or queen has the responsibility to ask if the other players want to play for the crown. If all challengers agree, the game becomes a game for the crown. However, trying to get the crown comes with a prize. Every challenger, so that means every player besides the current king or queen, needs to pay 3 copper to participate in a game for the crown. If the reigning king or queen wants to play, the king or queen has no right to deny the challenge, unless the crown was acquired in the past 12 hours. So that means the king or queen has at least 12 hours to enjoy the crown before it's on the line again. So that's how you start a game for the crown. The game itself isn't very different. You can play any game mode you want, and the winner of the game becomes or stays the king or queen of Catan. There's one difference when submitting the form. You have to select yes as the answer to the question, was it a game for the crown? So that's relatively simple. The last part you want to know is that a king or queen has the responsibility to keep the tournament active and alive. I mean, I named the whole tournament after your title, so that's the least you can do. I've developed a simple rule to motivate the king or queen to put the title on the line, which is the king or queen needs to play a game for the crown at least once in 7 days since winning the last game for the crown. So that's how you become king or queen of Catan. But because the tournament has a lot of players, the crown needs some help. Therefore, it has assigned titles to each game mode. They are called the Wardens of the Crown. And to become a Warden of the Crown, you have to beat the current Warden in the game mode he or she is the Warden of. It's a lot less complicated than winning the crown itself. The Warden title is always on the line if the holder of the Warden title plays the game mode he or she is the Warden of. To keep the battle for the Warden titles alive, there's one rule to follow. Play the game mode you're the Warden of at least once in the 12 days since you won the title. That's all. If you want to learn how to join King of Catan and how the tournament works, I recommend the video on the top. If you want to improve your knowledge of cities and knights, I recommend the video on the bottom, in which I give 9 actionable tips that you can apply to every single cities and knights game you play. I'm Trichosaurus, I hope you'll come play with us, and I wish you a good day.